following program is brought to you by the Internet Broadcasting Organization.
Hi, welcome to Sexually Educated. I'm your host, Amber Bentley.
Cherish Monique.
Callie Sterling.
Welcome. This week we talk about compromise within relationships and within sex. And yeah, we have some beverages as well. Cherish isn't really into our beverages. Mm-mm. I can't hear myself. It scares me. Anyways.
I can't hear you either.
You can't hear me either? Mm-mm. Anyways, yeah, whatever. So our recent sex topic is something we talked... What? What are you pointing at?
Maybe the...
There it goes. It got all over me. If that makes you feel any better, it got all over me. Not on the equipment. There, he's freaking out right now. Nothing got on the equipment. It got all over me. Fuck. I don't even get to play this game anymore. Anyways, it all got on me. It would get on me though. That's because you're pointing at something. Anyway, so now we can hear ourselves, which makes it better. You know what? You warned me too. It's all over me. Nothing else. If that makes you feel better.
It really is just all on me.
Thank God I don't like my clothes. You can just throw that.
Make sure what?
Thank you. Anyways, okay, so today we're talking about why we have red wine is because in this study, they talk about natural aphrodisiacs, and one of the natural aphrodisiacs is when women drink at least a glass of red wine every day, just one, and I've had like four today, so anyways, it makes them naturally hornier, which is just exciting because I only like red wine. Cherish, is that why you're not as horny as me?
It's possible.
you want me to get that? All right, I was just trying to be a nice guy.
He's just looking out for
you. Yeah,
I'm being a good friend.
You're being a great friend. But you did figure out how to turn this on because I knew something was wrong.
Yeah,
I blame the wine. It's not us. Anyways, so back to. I know it was good wine too. And I knew I shouldn't have poured myself a soda. It doesn't even matter anymore. I just, you know, my little tangents.
There's a special place in heaven for people who waste good wine.
In heaven?
And I was just saying heaven.
Yeah.
I think I already get to go there. So, and then one of the other ones, wine makes sense. Because, I mean, I have a rule about wine. Your first glass of wine, you're super duper, chill. It's like smoking a blunt. Not that I would know what that's like. Your second glass of wine makes you horny. And your third glass of wine makes you pass out. So, my system's legit. Because a girl that drinks, you know, two glasses of red wine. Maybe I just know how to drink wine better than other people. I don't know. It is what it is. And then, but another one on the study, this was super weird, was like man's natural hormones. Turn women on, like when a guy doesn't like wear deodorant.
Ew.
What?
That's gross. It's the pheromones. They said it's the pheromones.
I believe it.
No, absolutely. You don't. No, you don't.
Okay. How do male tigers attract female tigers?
We're not talking about tigers. We're talking about people.
We're nothing but animals. I'm just saying. We're nothing but mammals.
You and me, baby, ain't nothing but mammals. All right. Back to that. Anyways, yeah, but red wine. So, I mean, if you would like to get a girl in the mood, I suggest giving her a glass of red wine. Not all over her body like I just did. I was just showing you what not to do with red wine and around lots of equipment that everyone just warned you not to spill in front of. That's exactly what I was doing by drinking red wine.
I know a cheaper way. Just don't wear deodorant. Just saying.
I mean, if you do that, we'll see how many girls you attract.
Okay. Yeah.
I'm just saying, I'm probably not going to hang out with you that much anymore.
Why not?
I mean,
you might be attracted to me. Is that it? Are you scared?
Yeah, okay. That's what I'm afraid of. I'm afraid of like you letting off some like pheromones that get like all these girls. I'm afraid of that.
Okay.
Right. Yeah, I think I'm less afraid of that. Anyways, back to me. So tonight's conversation about compromise in sex and in relationships, because we all have to do it. I'm in not a relationship, but something, and I don't get to have sex as much as I like. And that's an annoying compromise. I think that is the worst compromise to have. Mm-hmm. You?
Having no sex?
Yes.
In a relationship?
I mean,
you mean with other people?
With each other.
No, why are we just staying out with each other? With both. I don't get to have sex with other people anymore either. I mean, that's I could.
And why aren't you guys having... Wait, you said you're not having sex?
We don't have sex as much as I'd like because we... Okay, first of all, we both work crazy schedules. Second, our relationship's not supposed to be all about sex. As you can tell, I'm super excited about that.
I'm assuming that's not your decision.
No, it's totally my decision not to get to have sex anytime I want. It's totally my decision. I mean, I'm just. That's all I'm saying. It's just, he's not watching tonight, anyways. But still, I know it's like, like there's sometimes I literally rape him. Can you say that? Can I say that without like? I mean, he's into
if
it.
If he's not pressing charges, then you're good.
Okay, good. Yeah, but like, I literally, like the other day, I was like, I want to have sex, and he was like, I think it's, you know, I was going to go home. And then all of a sudden I was like, yeah, I really want to have sex before I leave. And he was like, I think that, you know, you said you wanted to go home. It's kind of late. I was like, no, like we're having sex. And he's like, yeah, I think that, you know, and so I raped him. I mean, I didn't like rape him, but it was like willing rape, I guess, if that's what you, I think he was just playing hard to get with his penis. Are you even, I don't know if you're allowed to say any of this, but you are. I don't know. Anyways.
Did he say no?
No.
Then it's consensual.
He wasn't serious about it when he did. I guess I take that how you want. I don't know. Anyways, it doesn't matter. And then I was listening to this thing. We'll probably talk about this later. Coercion. Anyways, not compromise, but coercion. Like, they say, like, a majority of women, like, at first have to, like, coerce men into having sex, and then, but the men never, like, care afterwards. It's like, yeah, because we know what's good for you, vagina. Mm. I mean, just saying, like, you know, like, I knew that the vagina was good for him at that moment. I was like, listen, we haven't had sex in 4 days, 21 hours, and 26 minutes. Can we please have sex now? And it would be different if I was still having sex with other people, because then I wouldn't care because,
you just go get it somewhere
else. Yeah, you're not having sex with me? Okay, my phone just rang, so I'll see you later. But I'm trying to be a good person. It's really hard to be a good person when someone's not giving me sex as much as I need it. So that's probably why we're talking about compromise. It was actually his suggestion for the topic. So obviously, he thinks that I need some lessons in it or something. how do you feel about compromise?
Oh my gosh, I have an amazing story with your situation. It's a real life story.
Elephants?
A little bit more serious though. No, we're not talking about animals anymore. Anyways, how do I feel about compromise? I don't think you, I think compromise is almost everything in a relationship, to be honest with you.
It is.
Yeah. Because no two people are the same, so you're going to have different opinions of what you want out of the relationship and to make it work. So, like, you spilt the drink, I'm gonna wipe it up, give me a massage later. Compromise.
No? I mean,
no, this is not how it works.
I don't think. Okay, anyways, can we go to your story? We go to your story about elephants?
Story.
I'm drinking very far away from everything. See, my wine is over here. I don't even trust
She's
myself.
Dangerous.
Yeah, continue
so
with your
dangerous.
Story. I'm gonna sit over here for a minute.
Well, a friend of mine, someone close to me, anyway, was telling me about their story about compromise and how she only had sex with her husband of 4 years twice, mind you. And the compromise was he had some issues, and the compromise was he would go to counseling for his issues, and in return, you know, they would work things out. She would stay with him. And the moment, you know, he stopped, well, she has her needs. And as a husband, you have to fulfill your wife's needs. I've never heard of any situation where a man has that problem, but he, you know, it's not his fault, just how he grew up in certain situations or whatever. So anyways, he stopped going to counseling for whatever reason. And because of that, she ended the relationship. They got a divorce because that was the compromise. You keep going to counseling, we'll work on trying to have sex. They had sex twice. She waited till they got married to have sex. And then it was like, not that great either when they actually did.
Of course it wasn't. They waited till they're married.
It wasn't honeymoon night. It wasn't out of the 4 years. It wasn't honeymoon night. And it, I guess, happened twice somewhere in 4 years. Ridiculous. That is absolutely ridiculous. So
I'm just saying there's never going to be a relationship I'm in where I don't get to have sex for 4 years. I mean, unless like, I don't know. I don't see myself loving anyone that much.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Hey, by the way, we don't really have to have sex. No, that's not cool.
Well, but that's love. She compromised. She's like, okay, but you got to go to counseling because he couldn't. It's not that he couldn't because he had some issues. You know what I mean? He had some issues growing up and certain
Blah blah blah. I figure there's some sort of abuse there, which it's warranted. But at the same time, like 4 years, like you have to go to counseling. Like, what girl does not want her vagina touched for 4 years? Unless
sex
you're like a nun.
That's not her priority.
Don't lie, because if someone else isn't touching your vagina, you're touching your own vagina in that 4 years a lot.
Yeah, well, that's exactly. I can touch my own vagina.
No, I don't see you going for it. If you go,
we were talking about that, I'd be able to be a nun.
No,
then,
you would not.
But then the issue came up as, would I be able to touch myself?
Because you can't.
I don't think I can. They can.
Okay, first of all,
then probably I couldn't.
No. First, that's second. I don't think you could last 4 years. Maybe 8 months. I think that your limit would be 8 months.
And I've lasted a year.
That doesn't count. That's before. No.
No, this is after.
Oh, a year? Not sex at all?
Yeah.
I thought you were having sex with someone else.
What do you mean?
I thought, because there was a year with him, but I thought you were having sex with the other one in that year. Sorry, we're having a side conversation.
Yeah, she's having a side. I have no idea what you're talking about.
Okay, that's okay. It's gibberish. Anyways, as I said, I've drank way too much wine today. Anyways, so back to the story. I don't know. That for me... I understand compromise in relationships is necessary, especially with sex. Like, you're going to have, like, I was reading an article and it said, like, okay, obviously, like, there's some people that get really horny in the morning.
Yeah.
And some people that get really horny at night.
And there's people that are both horny.
I'm literally, this is how I describe it. I'm 5 degrees below horny at all times. If I get a dirty text message, I just went 2 degrees below horny. If you give me more than one text message that says, oh my gosh, I'm over it.
Yeah.
Like, at all times. Like, I'm like... Unless, like, something ridiculous is happening, like, I'm watching children play. Then I'm, like, negative. Like, I'm, like, there's no way I'm going to get horny anytime soon. Anyways, but, yeah, I'm usually 5 degrees below horny at all times. So, the fact, like, I could do it anytime. But, like, they were saying, like, if your husband, like, doesn't want it in the morning, you're going to have to start compromising and being able to do it at night. Or, you know, or in the morning or whatever. Because at some point, like, and then the couples that, even if they weren't really affectionate, because they say, like, affection is a type of intimacy, and like usually the couples that are willing to kiss each other more and hug each other more and more affectionate, not like those ones that are like disgustingly affectionate, like I have to touch you every minute of the day, not those ones, because those ones are annoying, but the other ones, those ones, the normal ones, yeah, those are like, that shows like a relationship satisfaction. So in those couples, the ones that were, even if they didn't have that same affection like we're talking about, if they were willing to compromise for sex, if they were willing to do it at a time of day or at a different, like more than they wanted to, they were more happy.
Kissing? Is that what you're talking about?
No,
willing to have sex,
compromise for their partner. And it shows relationship satisfaction, sexual satisfaction, because having sex a good amount in your relationship usually relates to relationship satisfaction in general. I don't even get to have this up here anymore.
I
lost my privileges. Anyways, I'm a big kid. I can do that to myself. Anyways, so yeah. But that's, I mean, I think that makes sense too. Like, if you're willing to compromise with your partner, obviously, one, the communication's there. Like, hey, I know you really don't like having sex in the morning, but I woke up with this morning wood. Can you please touch it a little bit? I don't know. I'm just saying.
What do they say about when you have children?
It didn't tell me about children. Why? Children? What about children?
Because, like, what if the person wants it in the morning, but then you have a child that's, like, awake and you can't really do it?
That's compromise, right? Mm-hmm. Then you have to have it a different time. Then you guys are going to have to plan to have it at 2 o'clock in the afternoon when your kid's at school or something like that.
What if you're both not home?
Do it at night?
What if your kid or someone else can hear you? Where are you having this compromise?
Be quiet. I mean, I don't...
Do it in the car?
You could do it in the car, yeah. Or the shower? Shower sex is okay.
I don't mind shower sex. You just have to... No. He has to stand in the water, and then you have to be facing out of the water.
Shower sex makes this horrible noise like this.
No, that's why he has to be standing
It's
in the
worst
water.
Noise in the world. That is what shower sex sounds like, right? I know.
That's awesome.
No, that's the worst sound.
You know what that tells a man? I'm doing my best.
No.
Have you heard the headboard? Same damn thing.
No, the headboard is completely different because And then shower sex, the girl usually ends up going dry and it's just awkward and then you slip a little bit and your foot like might slide one way and... Anyways,
I feel like you're only having that issue, Amber.
You need to do
that. Everyone I talk to doesn't like shower sex except you.
And I don't mind shower sex. It's fast and it's easy cleanup.
No, I don't. First of all, I don't want it to be fast and easy cleanup.
It's not like an infomercial.
But those are in the nights when I'm like, all right, I'm tired. You want it in? this is how you're gonna get it. Me showering and then us doing it, then and then I go to bed when I get out.
She's like, but I'm only showering for 10 minutes, so you have 5.5 of those minutes.
Let's be real, I shower for like 20.
Oh, so how many of those minutes does he get?
Like 5.
Because I was gonna say, because I know you limit a shower sex time. You're like, are you done?
Oh Lord.
Are you done yet? I'm over this. I'm so over this.
Best sound ever.
No, I hate it. That is what it sounds
it's
like.
Straight
though.
Pride and ego. That's all. Every single beat is ego. No. Yes.
No.
Yes. Thank you. I'm so glad you.
Oh my Lanta.
Oh yeah.
I do not know. There is no. I don't know. I don't like shower sex. Anyways, that's.
But what if he likes shower sex?
I'll do
Are
it.
You willing to
you
compromise?
You got to do it. Absolutely.
Yeah, we can have butt sex in the shower. That's my compromise. We'll have butt sex in the shower. Because butt sex is messy otherwise, but butt sex in the shower doesn't feel that messy because, one, you already have the lube there, you know? And then, two, it's in the shower. It's clean, you know? You just wipe things off when it's over. You don't have to worry about getting too messy.
Compromise with sex is kind of easy, I think. Very easy.
No, because couples are so afraid to talk about it. They're so afraid to be like, by the way, I like to be tied up. Is that cool with you? And they're like, no, actually.
No, but I'll do it because I like, never mind, let me stop.
No, but okay, yeah, but you say that, but a lot of people aren't. Like, okay, yeah. A group of my friends, they don't, remember when we went on our vacation and they didn't like giving blowjobs? Okay, mm-hmm. Or swallowing.
All the girls?
Or swallowing. The biggest point is the or swallowing part. I just have to add that or swallowing part. Okay, so they didn't like to give blowjobs first. Yeah. So could you imagine dating a girl and her being like, you know what? I don't like to put dick in my mouth.
I wish I had more hands so I could give them 3 thumbs down.
That's funny.
Yeah.
But then she's like, okay, well, I'll do it, but I'm not going to swallow it. Or she's like, you know, or like your thing is well, like, I like to nut on her face. And she's like, I don't like that on my face. It's so gross. But she didn't watch my show and she didn't know that I made her look younger. So she wasn't educated. Because then you'd be like, listen, baby, I'm just giving you a facial mask. I feel like that would work. I find myself way more humorous when I'm drunk, by the way.
No, you're always funny.
Oh, good.
All
good,
the time.
Good.
Yes. Yeah, but exactly. You gotta compromise. All right, so you don't really like to, but you're going to do it. All right, go in your mouth.
Nut. You could say nut.
Nut? I won't nut in your mouth. That's vulgar.
That's not vulgar.
That's vulgar.
Nutting in the mouth?
Jeez, that's so bad.
No. Okay. Splooge? I feel like splooge would be worse. I want a splooge on your face.
Oh my gosh. But yeah, no, definitely compromise there. All right, hey, babe. All right, thank you.
Okay, but okay, the girl's like, I do not give blowjobs. It's just not going to happen. That is not going here.
Don't expect me to go down.
Okay. Then everyone loses.
Yes.
But then what if she still won't blow you?
I'm going to tell you, though, I feel like you can convince them. Otherwise, too, you can convince them. They haven't had the right person to massage
make them comfortable.
It in. Exactly, make them comfortable enough for it. But everyone has a blowjob in them.
Everyone
get her drunk.
That is true. Get her drunk, then you can do anything. Get her drunk, and you could do anything. Like pretty much, not anything, but pretty much.
I don't know how I feel about that part.
Well, if you're together, it doesn't count.
Yeah, if
you don't know her and you're getting her drunk, then that's weird.
Yeah, we're not advocating rape, even though we've talked about it for like 10 times here. No, that's not what we're advocating. We're advocating
cool.
Humping.
No means no.
Unless they say it with a smile on their face. I'm just kidding. No, it's never okay.
That's bad.
I know it's never okay. It's never
no
okay.
Means no.
No.
Sometimes.
Unless you're a guy and he a girl and he's a guy. Then it's okay.
Then it's not rape.
Then it's not rape. Because it doesn't count. No, I can't say any of this. This is why we didn't win a talkie award. Damn it. If we didn't have such adult content all the time and said the word splooge. Anyways, I feel like not even in sex relationships, but like in like intimacy relationships, dating relationships, whatever, compromise is this big annoying thing, you know. Okay, I am a brat. I'm not gonna lie to you guys. I have to get my way. You know this about me. Everyone.
She is a brat.
Yeah,
big
if you
brat.
Yeah. Anyways, that's just us flirting. We're gonna do it later. in my head. Anyways, but that's not the point. The point is that, so you have, what was I talking? Brat, me being a brat. Anyways, huge brat, have to get my way all the time because I'm used to it. I was an only girl. I had a bunch of brothers. I got my way all the time. My parents were like, she's the girl, so she can pretty much do what she wants. So all that. So, and guys, like, I give vagina and blowjobs and I let them splooge on me. So usually I get my way with that. Is this not going anywhere? Anyway.
Stop saying
that word. We're cutting you off from that word.
I know. I know the word's so awkward, which is why I keep saying
you
it.
You get two a day and that's it.
you've exceeded your splooges for life. Anyways. Yeah. So, yeah. So I get my way. So in a relationship or something like that, I have to compromise. When people tell me no, I have to accept it, which I'm really, really bad about. Like, to the point where I will ignore someone for a whole day, even if I'm kind of dating them, if they tell me no the night before.
Because you're pouting. That's pouting. You're pouting. You're a grown woman.
I am a grown woman proud. I have to get my way.
Pouting about sex.
It's not always sex.
What else is there? What else pisses you off to the point you won't text them? Yeah, sex. That's it. That is it, sex.
It's like, no, but I don't say, hey, listen, you didn't have sex. I'm like, I wanted to hang out. Sex.
Sex.
I wanted to cuddle and watch a movie and you wouldn't come over, so now I hate your guts.
Sex.
But you do that to them sometimes too, so shouldn't that be a compromise?
Yeah, no, it's only, no. To see, this is why we're talking about compromise. Obviously, it's an issue.
You need a lesson in compromise.
I do need a lesson in compromise. I like my way. I like things to be my way. And when they're not my way, I like to not compromise, which I should learn to because everyone has to compromise. Mm-hmm. And that's the sex thing, though. I feel like I should definitely be getting it more than once in a half a week. I say half because sometimes it's only half. I don't know why. Oh, because I get really drunk and then I'm like, I can't have sex anymore. And that's like, so maybe that's why I don't get to have sex as much as I want. Because like we'll start having sex and then in the middle of it, I either get really sick or I'm just like, listen, I'm too drunk to keep going. And I don't know where this is.
Oh, so he's like, I'm cutting you off.
I don't know if that's
every now and then until you get your shit together.
No, I don't think that's it. I think he's kind of like, hey, by the way, you're a whore, so I'm not going to have sex with you as much. So I actually mean something to you. I think that's more so it.
No. Nobody likes drunk sex when one person is drunk.
We're both drunk together.
Obviously, he's not drunk enough because can't do it anymore. It doesn't matter what you say. You're going to keep going because you're drunk.
No. I literally like was on top and like jumped off and like sat on the, and I was like, I'm not going to have, like, I can't have sex anymore. I don't feel good. And he's like,
jump on,
he's okay. No. And then he started to, and then he's like, it was cool until you started snoring.
Wow.
I was like, did I tell you to stop having sex with me last night? He's like, yeah, you did. And I was like, oh. I was like, why did you listen to me? You could have kept going. He's like, no, I did. And then it was cool until you started snoring. And then I was like, oh, my bad. I only snore when I'm really drunk.
Oh, Lord.
Oh, golly. Yeah, that's the story of my life.
That's a very sad story.
I know.
Sad story for him.
I know.
So, Cherish, how do you feel about compromise?
So, anyways, Amber, you don't get to talk anymore.
No, that's not what I'm saying. I'm just going to keep this story going.
Okay,
so,
go.
Cherish, how do you feel about
compromise? I'm down for compromise. I compromise a lot. When I'm really tired, I let him put it in there. I feel like that's a compromise.
This is
my
not
sleep.
A real compromise.
That is compromise.
Sex is a win-win. What the hell?
Hell no. I love my sleep.
Yeah, I'm with you on that. Damn.
So I get very little sleep. So when I can get it, and me giving you sex, that's a compromise. When I'm rather like, oh, I'd rather be sleeping right now. But yes, I'll have sex with you. It's
Jeez.
Good. It's good. But I'm compromising my sleep for your sex right now.
Sleep is very important, actually.
It is.
Yeah.
But I don't know. I think compromise, we're all very open people as opposed to if we were to have someone here that was like, I don't let them do anything. That's my pretentious.
Like butt sex.
Yeah. You have to compromise on butt sex. I try to talk every girl into trying butt sex at least once.
Yeah.
At least
once. If your guy's into it, you got to do it every now and
then.
Even if
he's not, just try it. Even if he's not, just try it once. You don't know.
Well, what if he doesn't want to do it?
Doesn't matter. That's compromise. That's compromise.
You can't make him put it in your butt.
You obviously have never met me. I literally will pout. No, I'm just kidding. You won't put it in my butt. No, I don't do that. No, but seriously.
Why? Never mind. Butt sex? Yeah, I guess. It comes back to that giving head thing where, okay, well, we got to compromise. You got to give me some head. You know, make me happy. And I'll do something for you.
Yeah, okay. But then, oh, man. That, my ex, like, long time ago, he was not into eating vagina, which is just annoying as hell, because you have to be into eating vagina.
You don't have to be into eating vagina.
If I'm into eating vagina, he should definitely be into eating vagina.
There's tricks around that, I'm just saying.
Anyways, you have to be into eating vagina, just saying.
All right, some guys, they use their finger, and it kind of seems like a tongue, and it's really their finger.
No. Two totally different things. They feel different. It's different. It's
you
not
won't the, know because he's
you
down
will,
there.
You will know. A tongue is soft and wonderful. This feels like this. The difference between that. There's a big difference.
What if it's like wiggling and like, no, it doesn't, no.
No, you can okay. use your hands while you eat vagina, but you have to eat vagina. Anyways, that's not the point. The point is that, okay, so he would never, and then I was like, okay, well, I give you blowjobs like every day, so now I'm taking away the blowjobs. It took like a week of that, and he was like, eh, and I'm like, yeah, your dick's going to suck itself because you won't give me blowjob. Or
what if he really sucks at it, though?
I mean, he'll get better with practice.
But what if he doesn't?
Then I'll find someone new.
So you're not willing to compromise him?
Wow.
Not. Listen, how can you suck at eating vagina? Take a class or something.
Are there classes?
Is it on YouTube? No, because that's porn.
So watch porn.
Okay, so you're going to watch porn. No, it's never
right. Is that a reliable source, though?
It's very unreliable.
Because the girl is faking. An actor.
Exactly. It does not matter. The technique is there. Okay, here's something for everyone. If you want to know how to eat vagina, do the ABCs on a vagina.
What the hell's that?
Literally, your tongue in the ABC form.
So your tongue's motioning in cursive ABCs because you
Did I say cursive? Because I did not say cursive.
Okay, print, whatever. All right, my bad. It's not cursive. I don't understand.
ABCs, when your tongue does ABCs, it works. Don't
it works.
It does.
Do I start at, like, G?
Why would you start at G?
I'm just wondering because that's a lot
Why
of
Why would you start because you think you're a G? No. No, you start at A. You start at A
okay.
for Amber. Then you go to B for Bentley. Then you go to C for Cherish. Then you go for D for Dell. E for Ecstasy. I keep going.
She's
all
amazing.
Day.
Gosh.
Yeah.
She knows her alphabet.
I do. Anyways, that's not the point. The point is that there is compromise. You have to be able to willing to compromise sexually if you want to have a successful relationship. If yes. like, and that's like, I think agree. That, but compromise to an extent though, because where does the compromise end?
Well,
because you don't want to compromise your belief system.
Mm. So you don't believe in licking vagina, so you break up with them.
That's not, no. There's no such thing as not believing in licking vagina. I'm talking about like your religion.
Sex before marriage.
Yeah, so you don't believe in sex before marriage.
Sex before marriage. Yeah. Okay, I don't believe in it. So you're going to break up with me?
No, we would have to compromise on it. If we can't compromise on it, obviously we have to go our separate ways.
Okay, I'll pretend that I'm not here and you can have sex with me.
No, like, no, you don't compromise? Get to have sex till you get married.
Is blowjobs counted, like, included in that?
I don't know if the people say it does. Everyone has it. My mom thinks that blowjobs are part of sex. I informed her they aren't, but, you know, it's whatever.
That's not in the Bible, I don't think.
No, yeah, I don't, she has her own Bible, I suppose. No, but that's not the point. The point is that there's an extent, like, even in relationships, like, there's an amount of compromise that you can have. Like, obviously, in the beginning of the relationship, I feel like a lot of people compromise a lot more because they're, like, trying to be what the other person wants. Like kicking your roommate out so your guy can come live with you and you guys can be together forever.
Who would do something so shallow?
I don't know. Wow. Anyways, but no, compromise. Everything is compromise. You do not want to compromise your belief system. So, if you believe in satanic worship, then you should probably not be with a Jehovah's Witness or a Christian or something like that because you're going to compromise at some point some of your beliefs.
You're probably not together anyway. It's probably a hookup if you're even talking to that person.
But I'm saying, but that's not even the point. The point is there's an extent to, okay, sexual compromise.
Yeah.
You can say the person is into S&M or something that you try it and you're not into it, but they still want to do it. Yeah. What are you going to do then? You tried it. You tried it. But it's something like they only really can get aroused if you do this with them.
I'd let them get it from somewhere else.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah,
you'd let them step out of like almost somewhat an open relationship.
I don't know nothing about that. No,
Yeah. she's being serious. She's being completely serious.
Yeah, she is serious. That's crazy. So that's interesting. Let me stop. So, all right. So, okay. All right. Let's give like a real situation. Like you said, being tied up. So the person can't just do it. I don't understand.
They try it. They're like, I'll compromise for you. Yeah. But they have this horrible fear of being tied up or something. Or something. They have something.
And whips.
They're just not into it. That doesn't attract them or something. What are you going to do?
I think that, the thing is, compromise isn't always a two-way street. I'm going to let you know that right now. Sometimes you just got to give certain things up.
Sometimes you do have to take one for the team.
You do. Exactly. You just got to give some things up, and that might just be one of them.
But what if the guy can only get aroused that way?
Too damn bad.
Watch no porn.
Dick for you.
In those instances, maybe the two people, because there was a lot of articles and there were some saying compromise. There, you do have to take one for a team every once in a while. That's how it works, obviously. But there's going to be times when people just have different sexual desires, sexual fantasies, and the compromise is never going
to
work.
But could you go to parties and then just watch the other people and then the guy would get turned on and then you'd go home and do it?
That's not always how it works, though.
Yeah, you probably get limp dick by the time you stop at McDonald's and get some cheeseburgers and then go home.
Why would you stop at McDonald's getting cheeseburgers?
People get hungry after.
I just don't understand. You just watching people have sex and
you need to get that McDouble.
I'm done with you. Sauce. You're like promoting McDonald's and that's gross in general.
McDonald's is disgusting, actually. That's a whole other subject. Let's talk about food one day. Anyways. No, all right. So, but what if he doesn't last that long or whatever? You know what I mean? He can get soft by the time you get home.
Okay, well then just have a big enough car.
Or do it in
their house.
Okay, but then, here's another compromise. Your man has a small wiener. Okay?
I have that problem.
Huh? I have that problem. I bet you do. Your man has a small wiener?
Yeah,
that's exciting. I mean, that sucks.
Hey, relax.
I don't have that problem. You've gone too far. Anyways.
Yo, relax with that.
Anyways.
So
he has a not-so-big member. And you're having sex with him all the time, and then it's just not up to par. And you're like, oh, okay, well, I really like big wieners. So then you can't compromise.
Yes, you can.
His penis is never going to get bigger.
You can get toys. Let him get his, but you can use toys to help you out, or he could use the toys.
Mm,
the Great American Challenge.
You do make a good point.
It's crazy.
You do make a good point.
I'm just saying.
You do make a good point.
It's there.
Anyways, the real point of this is that compromise is very nice, but it's not always going to happen. You're not always going to be able to compromise. Mm-hmm. You're not always going to be able to say oh, hey, by the way, I like getting my butt licked. And they're going to be like, oh, I like licking butt. See? Look at your face. I feel like that's something
I'm not an ass man.
I feel like you want to compromise on that.
No.
Exactly.
Do they have tongue condoms?
It doesn't matter, condom or not, you better cut this thing off. That's the only way it's going over there.
But that's a compromise. That's a compromise.
Okay, all right, so I'm going to say no, so then we're going to
compromise. But you're not even going to try it once.
Not even a little bit.
See?
I'd get a dog. I'd be like, yeah, I'll do that for you.
Note to self, only have sex with Cherish in your head. Anyways, back to you guys.
I would not like your butthole.
Yeah. I wouldn't either. I'm not going to lie to you. I actually hate getting my butt licked. It's weird and awkward all at once. It's just not a good time. And I'm definitely not licking a guy's butt.
No.
I can't say that I'd never have. I just don't prefer it. I would never do it again.
Consciously.
Sorry.
All right, so you're one of those that will try anything once type of thing?
Anything that does not include me getting pooped on or peed on, yes.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
Huh?
I've been peed on, but it was in the shower.
In the shower does not count, by the way.
You're right. Don't pee on me in the shower. Don't give a damn.
I've been peed on in the shower. I care, but I don't care that much because I'm in the shower and I'm going to wipe off my leg anyway. But I swear,
I just had this conversation 2 days ago. Not even. About getting peed on in the shower. Get out of the shower.
What if a jellyfish stings you and the only way to cure you?
Pee all over me. You gotta call me R. Kelly. I don't care. You could, yeah, you could pee on me. You could, yeah, totally. I know.
But not in the shower?
That's his compromise.
On the beach in front of everybody.
But not in the shower?
No.
That's silly. That's silly. That's
circumstances.
Silly. No, it's the shower.
Mm-mm. People Mm-mm. drink their pee. Come on.
With filtration.
Bear Grylls?
With filtration, right?
No.
You're just peeing it.
Okay, anyway.
This isn't Survivor, man. I'm not trying to survive my relationship.
You are, though.
Yeah, but, okay, so you're saying, oh, she's into, or he's into peeing on me in the shower. That gets him aroused.
Yes.
I think he can hold off on that. I'm pretty sure she can hold off
I'm
on
sure
that.
I'm sure that would be compromised.
Yeah, I mean, okay, that's something, but I feel like it could be, but you'd have to have that conversation. Which is probably why these people have more sexual satisfaction, because they're having these conversations. Mm-hmm. Open communication, like, hey, by the way. Hey, by the way, once in a while when you're giving me a blowjob, I like a finger stuck in my butt. Awesome, yeah, I'll do that once in a while.
Or like a hairbrush, and I've heard it all. But like, okay, so the girl's not into it, but she'll do it just because he likes it. So then what you're saying is, so since she does that, well, he needs to go down on her. But no. Even though he's not into it.
That's okay. I'm not saying that. Oh, like, it doesn't always have to be like something this else. For that. Yeah, it doesn't always have to be this tat, for that. Right, tit right, for tat. Right. I was going to say that, yeah. Someone actually I didn't say it because someone commented on my, do you see that tit for twat? They put like, that's where the expression tit for twat comes from. Anyways.
Oh, Lord.
Yeah, not the point. Yeah. The point is, yeah, it doesn't always have to be like, well, you did this for me, so I'm going to do this for you. Sometimes you just do it because, you know, like me, I'm very open. The only thing I don't want to do is get peed on or pooped on or anything like that. So in most cases, I'll be like, okay, they'll be like, hey, let's try this. I'll be like, oh, I'm definitely down for that. I don't expect him to always be down for me like the same way I am, but I do expect him to have a conversation with me about it and tell me, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, hey, I like to be tied up.
Into this.
Not really into that, but you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It always has to be like that.
Yeah.
But anyways, yeah. The only thing you should never compromise is on protection.
What? We're married now.
No.
What if they say, do they just want to put it in your butt?
Like always, ever, only?
Yeah, but no, I'm saying just every now and then, since you're like, well, you're not putting it in me raw, so you can put it in my butt every now and then raw.
I mean, you should never have any kind of sex without condoms on.
Unless you have your test report in front of you.
Yeah, unless you have your test report. And by the way, anal sex, as enjoyable as it may be at times, is one of the easiest and quickest ways to catch an STD, just in case you're wondering.
Well, geez, it's kind of dirty in there. So.
It's like an open wound.
Oh, that's gross. All right, so a website's telling me that when you compromise, like when not to compromise, when you compromise, it's compromise is a failure to meet one's own needs. So what it's saying is you don't want to compromise to meet the other person's need or your own needs, rather. That's failure.
Yeah. So you want to do it tit for tat. You want to do it. I'm going to compromise this for you just so I can get this from you.
It's saying do not do that.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Okay. We're speaking the same language.
Hey, I'm agreeing with you.
We're speaking the same language over here. No, that's totally, I agree with you. You should never do that. And it's just, I don't know. But I feel like people in relationships and in general, not just in sex or whatever, but I feel like people do a lot more compromising than they probably should. Like, oh, hey, by the way, it's cool that you go out with your guys every, five nights a week. That's cool, right? That's a compromise that you should probably not be doing. Because, I mean, no one, I don't know.
Maybe she just trusts him.
It has nothing to do with trust.
Absolutely.
No.
Go out with your friends. I'm with you all the time anyway.
If you're going out with your guys 5 days a week, you're with her all the time? No, you're not. No, you're not.
Nobody realistically who has a girlfriend goes out with their guys 5 days a week.
I know people.
I wouldn't want to go out with my homeboys 5 days a week.
If you have a girl. Exactly, because that's a compromise. Well, okay, a compromise. Hey, could you not go to the strip club without me?
Nah, she's going to have to give that up every once in a while. She's got to let the boys have their night.
Okay. Yeah. What if she says, okay, go to the strip club without me, but don't get a lap dance?
It's a lap dance.
Nope, let's be real here. Let's be real here because we live in Trampa. We both know that lap dances aren't always just lap dances.
I wouldn't know.
Okay, you might not know, but I've been with multiple guys when they went to get a lap dance and they fingered the girl. They freaked the girl. they freaked the girl, or they got a blowjob from the girl. These are our strip clubs. This is lap dances. I agree. That's a compromise, though. That's like, okay.
Well,
okay.
It's like one of those things. They're saying don't get a lap dance. I'm sure they're saying don't have sex with that girl, too.
Yeah. Yeah, I feel like that's like, but like, I mean, things happen. You could be drunk at the strip club, and if you get that lap dance, she's like, here's $200. She's like, you want to slide it in? He's like, well, you know, I'm drunk.
Yeah.
You put yourself in that position.
Was she hot? Was she clean?
Oh, Lord.
Let's be real here. She's probably not clean. But if she's like, $200, she could slide it in. She's probably not clean. Just saying.
You never know.
Anyways.
I see what you're saying. Don't judge. You're right. I'm going to come around. You're right. Well, she likes that word. She likes those two words. You're right.
That's how you take me from 5 degrees to 0 degrees in 10 seconds. You're right.
You're right.
I don't know why, but every time. Anyways, continue on.
So, all right. So, yeah, as far as that goes, okay, you can't.
Hey, everybody, that's your birth control reminder. Meow. Anyways, you can continue. We just have to say that every week.
Yeah, no, absolutely. Part of
sexually
awesome.
Educated.
That is awesome.
Continue.
Love it.
I'm going to drink some wine while you talk.
All right. So when you go to the strip club, we're going to be like, all right, cool. I won't get a lap dance. But when I get home, you better take care of me. Doesn't matter if you're sleeping or you're awake, cleaning or something. I don't know what women do when they're by themselves. Reading a book on their iPad. On their iPad.
You said we clean, though.
I also said reading a book.
How chauvinistic of you.
Listen, I covered it up right with her reading a book. On her iPad. I don't know what women do when they're alone.
I dance.
I'm just assuming.
I dance
she dances
too.
To no music at all, right? Like, just by yourself. No.
It depends. Sometimes it's no music at all.
No, all right. I have music.
Sometimes.
I'm not crazy.
What does that say about me?
I'm anyway, just kidding.
Continue.
I'm just totally kidding. But yeah, all right. So they're reading on their iPad or they're watching a movie. Women watch movies by themselves, like romantic movies, like Notebook and all that.
I watched Anger 2 by myself the other night.
Okay, but when I come home from the strip club, you better take care of me because these women are looking mighty attractive and I need somewhere to release this energy.
Okay, but let's be real on two fronts. One, even if you were single, you're probably not banging any of those strippers depending on what strip club you went to.
No. They look good. They turn me on.
Okay, exactly. But so the strip club, okay. Two, yeah, I mean, that's a compromise. That's like, okay, you can go. Please don't get a lap dance. I'll give you a lap dance when you get home.
Oh. Okay.
My favorite story is like, okay, so one of the exes and I, we were like, I was passed out. He woke up, because he woke up early in the morning for work, but he couldn't go back to bed. It was a weekend and he wanted to have sex and we had already had sex. I'd got mine. I passed out. I guess like 3 hours later he didn't. And he was like, hey, what are you doing? I'm like, I'm fucking sleeping, dude. Like, you clearly can see that I'm sleeping.
Mm-hmm.
And so he pushed me again. He's like, I can't sleep. I'm like, okay. Mm-hmm. He's like, I need you to help me go to sleep. So I literally roll over and just literally put my butt in the air. I was already naked, so I was just like, just go. And he fell asleep. That was compromise. That was love.
That was love.
I was sleeping, but I literally was like half sleeping during the whole thing.
Yeah.
But I mean, he got his. He was able to sleep, so that was compromise.
Because you have no, you get nothing out of it, so.
At that point, I'm getting nothing out of it. Yeah. I'm losing sleep. I'm not getting anything.
Yeah, you're probably sleeping.
I was like half sleeping. I was literally like...
You don't got to front the kicking. I was just saying.
Yeah. I was probably sleeping.
You're probably sleeping.
I was more than likely sleeping while he was doing it. Jeez. I don't really remember the whole process, so yeah, probably. At least I wasn't snoring that time. Two different people. Obviously, this is a problem. Anyways, but no.
Oh. So, like you were saying, at what point do you draw the line? At what point do you say enough's enough? At what point do you say, like, we got to get a divorce or we got to end this relationship?
Are you asking?
I'm asking you. Where's the line?
When you're compromising too much. You're compromising more than yourself. When you're giving up your own personal needs to meet someone else's needs. Mm. Like, wants, yes. Desires, that's fine. But when you're giving up your own personal needs to give someone else, that's when the compromise ends. Hey, by the way, I'm gonna pay your bills for you and take care of you and make sure you're taken care of, and my bills will suffer. That's not compromise. At that point, you're giving up more of yourself than you should be.
Okay,
and that's where people start, you know, if it's something you're uncomfortable with, you know, I like to bang a bunch of girls, so if we're going to date, I'm going to have to like bang like 7 girls every day.
What would that be the point of being together?
Exactly. But there's points, and even like in relationships and in sex, there's points where you're never going to compromise because it's never going to work out that way. Sex is a lot easier to compromise because if you're having an open conversation, if you're being open about everything you're doing, then compromising's easy because you're talking about it. You're not always going to be able to, you know, get what you want out of it, but at least you tried it or something like that. If someone's unwilling to compromise you with you, especially in sex, I feel like that's a off, like it should be turned off immediately.
Everybody has their limits. Like I can't be peed on, and what there's no compromise for that. That's it.
No, but those I feel like pee and poop, that's like legitimate, like no. But what are they like, hey, by the way, I want you to dress up like a furry animal and spank me. you wouldn't try it once if you were in love, madly in love. You wouldn't try it once.
If I'm madly in love, I will do anything for that person.
Exactly the point. That's compromise. Obviously you're not going to be comfortable dressing up like a furry animal spanking them.
That'd be awesome.
You're such a creep. Hey, what kind of furry animal?
Any of them.
An elephant?
What?
If you dress up like
that's
a
not furry though.
If you dress up like a tiger, then Dell doesn't have to wear any deodorant, so you're good on that.
You see how she set it up, but it wasn't a home run. It's more like T-ball. Goes nowhere. Goes. All right, listen. Well, a friend of mine, she told me her compromise because she was in a serious relationship. She said all she can say is compromise. Do not compromise so much that time passes and you have lost time and what your dreams are. So, like exactly like you said, don't give up too much of yourself. Because at that point, you're not the same person. You're not who you are.
Exactly. And that's why they started dating you or wanted to be with you in the beginning, is because, you know, you were this person. When you compromise so much of yourself, you start to lose that person.
Yeah.
And if you, that's again what I'm saying, like, don't compromise your needs.
Yeah.
You know, if you need water, don't give everyone your last drop of water. Maybe give them half of it. You know, give what you can without taking away from yourself.
Yeah.
And that, I think, is compromise in sex and in relationships. Mm. So if you feel like we fulfilled this conversation, so now it's time for tip of the week.
Give me my tip of the week. My tip. Why does got to be like that? I was just saying, I'll give you my tip of the week.
Because you always got to get dirty with it, so then I got to be an idiot.
He wasn't dirty. He was saying. Dirty.
He said it all sexual. Mind. He said it like barely.
That was you. You heard it that way.
I am drunk, so that is quite a possibility. Anyways, continue on.
Callie Sterling's tip of the week. Nah, let me stop. Anyways, so
just a tip.
If you have sex every day, try going 2 days just no sex and see what happens after those 2 days.
I don't like that tip.
You don't like that tip?
No, continue on. It's a good tip.
You're using from that the tip woman, right now.
I'm getting that tip
on
right now.
On accident.
I'm getting it like once every 5 days.
All right, fine. Another one.
No, it's a good tip. It's a good tip.
It's a solid tip.
It's just killing me right now. So we get to have sex tomorrow, right?
It'd be like pent up aggression, like later. It'll be exactly. Like amazing.
No, I'm not. Exactly. Okay, I will say this. For the relationship I'm in, the sex that I don't get to have, when we do have sex, it is a step above. I'm like, not just because he's great, but because like I'm just like I'm way more into it, because I mean I was having sex probably way too much for not being in a relationship and with way too many people. But that's not the point. The point is that it could work. It's probably a good tip. I just, you know, whatever.
It's a good tip.
Totally. Tip of the week. Your turn.
For girls that can't last long on top, my advice is find something to hold on to. It's easier to bounce that way, like a headboard. You can have grip, so
it's a good, it helps your leg on the ground.
Yeah, and for the guys, help them out a little bit. You want her to stay on top longer? Help her out. Thrust, pick her up.
Her ass, hold her ass. That is the best way. Like, she's already on top of you. You get to touch her butt while she rides you. That I like that one. That's a good tip.
You know what works?
That's a good tip.
Like putting your arms
Cherish has a better tip than you. Anyways, continue.
She has a better everything than anyone ever, all right? I'm just saying. If you put your arms up under the girl and that can help because your arm strength leverage. Is there.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you just help her and she'll help you.
That is. Or she can hold on
compromise.
To you.
You're compromising
exactly.
Your guys' body pain.
You guys can't just throw that word into everything.
No, true story though, with my ex and I, when we used to have sex, I like hated being on top. Uh-huh. And he was like the only guy I ever hated being on top because he was so, he was such a crybaby. He'd be like, your ass keeps hitting my balls. And I'm like, you do realize this is sex, right? Like, that's sex. That's what I said. That's exactly. Needless to say, well, we're not together anymore. But anyway, no, he'd be like, when you do that, my leg starts to hurt. Oh, shut the hell up. And
is he really crying?
Huh?
He's really crying right now. Like
he was literally, like, in the middle of sex. In the middle of sex, he would literally, like, be like, ah. And then I started cheating on him, and I was like, oh, I'm good at sex. Because, yeah, exactly. The other guy didn't cry every 5 minutes. He's like, anyways, my tip of the week is tie her up. This is just tie her up and go down on her.
Oh, heck no.
Yes.
I'd fight.
I feel like it'd be great. No, tie her up and go down on her. Yeah. Do not let her touch you. Do not let her hands touch you. Blindfolding was nice too. Yeah,
because then she can't see and she can't do anything.
Dude, could you imagine someone do that to you?
Someone has done that to me.
Well, how'd it feel?
I freaked out.
But you liked it?
I was freaked out.
You liked it?
Tickled me. Freaked out.
Anyways, tying up or like you know oh you're having sex when you're having sex doggy style, grab her hands, put them behind her back, and just go like that. That's another. Mm. That's. Kinky things. Kinky
signature
things.
Moves right there.
Yeah, exactly. Tip of the week. Oh, I like, but Cherish's tip of the week does win for this week. I do give you props on that. Maybe we should do tip winners. You won the tip.
Can we get like gummies or like penis gummies and then like, oh, you get a gummy.
I don't even want to win at that point.
They could be boobs too.
Hey.
Hey. Yeah. Anyways, this has been Sexually Educated with your host, Amber Rose Bentley.
Callie Sterling.
And Cherish Monique.
Next week we'll have less messy red wine everywhere. Thank you for watching and have safe sex. Until then.
Ride hard.
Wrap it up.
Ooh, you guys are good.
Wrap it up.
Wrap it before you tap it. We'll be right back.
This program was brought to you by the Internet Broadcasting Organization, setting the standard for new media broadcasting.